heaping pounds of freshly ground plankton?
Yeah, maybe this wasn't a joke. Hello, YouTube! It is your friendly neighborhood Reaper, and today we are going over a horror comic called The Secret Formula by the amazing Pop-Tart Co-op, aka Marcus Yu. Instead of the vibrant, colorful world we cherished in our childhood, this comic is presented in black and white. This contrast may foreshadow the dark themes that we're about to encounter, or maybe that is just his art style, as other comics are presented in the same way. Either way, I love the spooky vibes. In the show, Plankton is constantly scheming to steal the secret Krabby Patty formula from Mr. Krabs. For those who don't know, Plankton and Mr. Krabs were childhood best friends. They were even born on the same day at the same hospital. And remained friends throughout grade school. Later on, they became business partners in a burger business. However, the burgers were just plain awful. One day after an argument, Plankton stormed off to fix the recipe. Meanwhile, Mr. Krabs accidentally discovered the Krabby Patty secret formula. From that moment on, he refused to share it with Plankton and started his own business. Since that day, Plankton swore he was going to steal the recipe. The story begins with Plankton finally uncovering the secret formula. But at what cost? Secret formula for Krabby Patties. Anchovies. 1 teaspoon. Gary slime. 4 cups. Crab meat chopped. Chum. 2 tablespoons. Plankton chopped. Sponge. 1 cup. 2.5 cup. Plankton was experiencing a mix of intense emotions. Pure shock. Disbelief. A profound sense of betrayal. Fear. Sadness. Anger. Rage. He was going through it. All of a sudden, Mr. Krabs began to reach from behind him. Chapter 2. Fortunately, Plankton managed to slip past Mr. Krabs, who screamed out in fury Plankton's name. Fueled by adrenaline, he sprinted through the dimly lit streets, his tiny heart pounding in his chest. He didn't stop until he reached SpongeBob's house, desperately calling out for him. To his shock, the door was already open. He was met with horrific sight. SpongeBob was nowhere to be found. His eyes fell upon Gary's shattered shell, lying in fragments on the floor. SpongeBob's precious pet now lays lifeless. Chapter 3. Plankton and Karen are seen to be in a remote shelter. Bro looks so done with his life. Plankton briefs Karen on the cruel reality of their situation. He is on the verge of giving up and states that he does not want to do this anymore. Karen says to suck it up. Just kidding. Karen says, "I'm sorry, Sheldon, but Krabs can't get away with this and you have to do something. Krabs has access to all of Bikini Bottom's CCTV, and so do I. If we play this right, we can find SpongeBob." With tears shimming down his face, he questions how they were going to pull this off. Karen states that out of hundreds of cameras, there's only one that has been illicitly shut off. It's located within an underground storage unit in Rock Bottom. Yep, that creepy place where SpongeBob wandered up because he missed his bus stop. If there's one place Krabs would abduct someone, it would be there. Beside you is a bracelet you can communicate with me through it. But you're gonna have to insert the bracelet's comms piece into the circuit breaker so I can restore power to the camera. Plankton blankly stares at the bracelet. You're not letting me go into Rock Bottom alone, are you? Unfortunately, Karen is unable to go because she needs to restore the power. Karen then gives Plankton a tablet. It will show him the inside of the storage room once the power is restored. It will tell him if SpongeBob is actually inside or not. She encourages Plankton to take the next bus to Rock Bottom before it's too late. Basically, Karen will be the guy in the chair and guide him.
Can I be your guy in the chair?
What? Chapter 4. After what feels like an eternity, Plankton finally reaches his destination, Rock Bottom. The silence is broken by Karen's voice crackling through the bracelet guiding him. 4 blocks straight, your destination should be on the left. As always, the place was eerie and unsettling. Plankton sees the circuit breaker and places Karen into the empty slot. I guess this is it, states Plankton while Karen reassures him that everything's gonna be okay. Their plan worked, but it was far worse than they had thought. Chapter 5. He burst through the door, desperate to save him. SpongeBob! He kept shouting. SpongeBob was chained up and Plankton frantically searched for the light, but SpongeBob pleaded with him not to turn it on. Please, no, wait! SpongeBob cried out. Plankton could barely recognize what was left of him, but everything began to make sense. Sponges can regenerate and grow when cut.
You mean like this?
Mr. Krabs has been harvesting an unlimited supply of sponge for his Krabby Patties, keeping SpongeBob barely alive to do it. SpongeBob said, "I'm sorry, Plankton. You were never the bad guy. Not you. I should have never listened to Krabs. I never meant you harm, Plankton. I never meant to hurt anyone in the Bikini Bottom. I promise." Tears kept flowing from Plankton's eye. SpongeBob had a dying wish and begged Plankton to put him out of his misery. He wanted to be free from the pain. "Please," he begged. Chapter 6. Plankton does not know if he has it in him to pull the switch and kill SpongeBob. SpongeBob pleads with him, "I'm sorry, Plankton. It shouldn't be you. But you can be my friend for just one moment, right?"
"Death is for friends who do stop together."
They both begin to weep. "It is okay," mutters SpongeBob. "I can't," yells out Plankton. SpongeBob was the beacon of light that Bikini Bottom needed. "Yes, you can. Just take a deep breath and save me." Plankton was in agony, but SpongeBob was in an unfathomable amount of pain and he needed to help him. Rest in peace, SpongeBob. While in the process of mourning his friend, all of a sudden a metal door slid down, trapping Plankton inside. "No!" Plankton yells out. Then he starts to hear a voice coming through the intercom. Chapter 7. "You monster," Plankton yelled. "Come on, Plankton. All these years thinking me formulaire would salvage your business? No. It was never about the Krusty Krab. It was about protecting the little fish brains of the Bikini Bottom. You're a vile, worthless crab, scraping every penny to fill that pathetic void inside your shell. I saw what's in that formula. You stole everything from me, you bastard." "I'm a chum. You're not getting away with this," yells Plankton. "Okay, but like, let's talk about this. I'm 100% Team Plankton, obviously." Okay. "But like, Plankton's chum is literally chopped fish. Why is Homie acting surprised that fish don't want to eat chopped fish? Also, we don't know where he's sourcing this fish. Are they really all that different? No wonder they're childhood friends." "Like, huh?" "You're the monster for killing SpongeBob," grumbles Mr. Krabs. "You're the one that pulled the lever." Mr. Krabs announces that he's going to leave Plankton here to rot and is going to continue pleasing his customers. "The riches of the Krusty Krab shall be bountiful, something ye have yet to understand."
Dang, he really did just call Plankton broke.
Goodbye, Plankton. Chapter 8. Bum-tiddy-bum! Karen to the rescue. She finds Plankton shriveled up and half dead. "Dang, I wonder how much time it has been. Oh, Sheldon, can I please? Wake up," Karen yells. It wasn't until then where she finally notices SpongeBob's corpse chained up. "Oh, mercy." "Darling," Plankton mumbles. Karen promises that she'll get him out of there. She apologizes for taking so long and asks what happened. Apparently, Mr. Krabs put toxins in SpongeBob's body and it was leaking out and it made his limbs rot. Plankton mumbles, I'm sorry for always causing you trouble. The chum bucket. I just wanted to make us happy." Again, Karen reassures Plankton that they were going to get through this together. Chapter 9. In a remote shelter, Karen rushes Plankton to a machine, begging him to stay with her and to please let this work. While working, she states, "You gave me life, Sheldon, all those years ago. Please let me give you yours. Please, Sheldon." Chapter 10. Plankton slowly starts to wake up after his surgery. "But where am I?" he mumbles. Low-key, it is giving Pickle Rick.
"I'm a pickle, when I feel like it."
Karen explains that they are safe and far away from Mr. Krabs. She also apologizes if he didn't like his new body. She was doing the best she could with what she had. She wanted to give him life, how he did for her. He showed her what it meant to be alive. Plankton thanks her and asks where Krabs is. Karen mentions that he's about to close down the Krusty Krab. Plankton vows that he's going to put an end to this and finally finish what he started. He yelled, "I will not let another innocent soul be tortured by Krabs." "And what do you suggest, Sheldon?" "Now Krabs pays his due. He will pay for the wrath of Neptune. I shall make him repent. Or SpongeBob." Chapter 11. I have always played by his rules, played it fair. It's time he plays against my rules. Hopefully, this time he doesn't run out of gas. Chapter 12. Mr. Krabs gazes outside the Krusty Krab, content with himself, after another bountiful day. Then, out of nowhere, a metal arm reaches behind him. I'm sorry, I can't. I can't with how Mr. Krabs looks right here. Plankton forcefully throws Mr. Krabs, causing him to crash into his desk. Although there was a warning at the beginning, this chapter is a bit more gory than others, so viewers be warned. Plankton viciously rips Mr. Krabs' arms off as he screams in agony. It's hilarious how it took Eve this long, muttered Krabs. Plankton isn't taking any of it. SpongeBob suffered. Suffered beyond comprehension, and now you shall pay. And you'll never get him back ever. It's already over, Sheldon. Do what you must. But the game's over. I've made me a fortune. And that insufferable brat SpongeBob is gone.
Okay, but money has no value when you're dead, buddy.
Condemn me as much as you wish. Nothing will ever replace that greedy brute behind your worthless shell. Mr. Krab yells out. Curse you, Plankton. I was never that envious, low-life insect that you are. You can only dream of me success.
If being successful means eating my friends, I don't think I want that, bro. What?
And that'll haunt you forever, Plankton states. None of it matters anymore. It'll end tonight. While sitting in a pool of his own blood, Mr. Krab yells out. You're nobody. You've never been anything. Rotten hell, insect. I am nobody. But SpongeBob wasn't. Chum on this, you crustaceous cheapskate. Plankton pierces Mr. Krabs' shell and splits him in two. Goodbye, Eugene.
Breaking news!
Eugene Krabs, the owner of the Krusty Krab, has been discovered dead inside his restaurant. This tragic event follows the mysterious disappearance of SpongeBob SquarePants. After 6 grueling weeks of searching, SpongeBob's remains have been found in a storage facility in Rock Bottom, 26 miles from his home in Bikini Bottom. Authorities are now investigating Krabs' longtime rival Sheldon Plankton of the Chum Bucket for any connections between the death of SpongeBob and Krabs. However, Plankton's whereabouts remain suspiciously unknown. Some speculate that this may have been a premeditated act, as tension between Krabs and Plankton have persisted for decades. Despite this, no final verdict has been reached. Plankton and Karen stare blankly at the TV. Karen tells Plankton not to worry. Shortly, she will release all of her recorded footage of Mr. Krabs. Soon, their names will be cleared, and the entirety of Bikini Bottom will finally know the truth. Plankton states, I've done my part, I think, to let those who matter know. Patrick reaches down and picked up a vase. He slowly turned it over. It read, Gary. Patrick bursts into tears. Karen says, we'll just have to lay low until then. You can rest now, Sheldon. Finally, SpongeBob and Gary found peace. And that's a wrap. Listen, SpongeBob horror goes hard. Again, special shout out to the creator Marcus. His art is absolutely amazing. You can even get a paperback version of this comic off of Amazon. I will definitely link it in my description below. I personally love the fan theory that the secret formula is actually made out of crab. Where are the other crabs in Bikini Bottom? Why is the Krusty Krab shaped like a crab trap? Make it make sense. Thank you so much for watching. Again, I am so sorry for the delay in videos. I recently started working a lot longer hours and I'm trying to adjust my schedule to it. Also, someone tried to steal my car. That was not fun. If you enjoyed the video and you want to see more, hit that like button and subscribe. Bye!